Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the workshop. And we must congratulate you that you all have gathered here at a very short notice. I mean, the letter was issued on first, and you all are able to come. I think few states are still missing. MP is not seen around. MP? Acha, you're there. Okay.
Only
okay,
Maharashtra, thanks. I think.
Is. Maharashtra is missing. So you must have seen all our just creatives and everything, and you must have developed fairly good idea about the Angikar as a campaign. Here we would like to just give you the overview and the whole architecture and the purpose why we are doing this Angikar. Yes, sir already has informed you about and explained why what the purpose of Angikar is. So broadly, the thinking is we are standing today at the approval of already more than 88 lakh houses, where more than 50 lakh has been grounded also. So now is the time we have spent more than 4 years of the mission, and this is the right time where many more than 26 lakh houses are already completed. So if we are able to change their behavior in terms of adaptation of the best practices and link them with the basic services, so this is opportune time. And we are gathered here, we will be acting as a master trainers, and our main responsibility is to get the whole complete understanding of how Angikar, and this roll it out at the state level and the city level subsequently. So our role is very critical. So we, whatever questions you have, whatever queries you may develop, you can ask us, you can call us later also, you can call us. So if we see this Angikar, the whole philosophy of Angikar that we have derived from the Gandhian philosophy, where he said, like, which is clean, green and healthy, litter-free India. That was the dream of Mahatma Gandhi. So that is the point where we are drawing from the whole inspiration. And since we are celebrating also 150th birth anniversary of Gandhiji, so this is the time where we'll be taking these thoughts and the dream which he had across India. So if we see, like, why Angikar? Okay, what is the purpose of this? So as we have been hearing our Honorable Prime Minister also, we have been saying the house is not only about four walls and a roof. It's a complete, life transformation is happening after getting this pakka house. So it's not only about the house, but all the basic services that a house requires. The basic services like water supply, electricity. So it's a complete package. And you might have also remembered, in last year, June, our Honorable Prime Minister also interacted with the beneficiary of the different states through the video conferencing. There also the insistence was, and the more focus was, to how to converge all the services. So you might recall also our Honorable Prime Minister was asking, have you got gas connection, for example? So it is not only house. If the PMAY is providing house, pakka house, that is the mandate. But it's not only house, all the services which a household may require to have a very good life, fulfilling life, that we need to converge. So that is the purpose why this Angikar has been launched. So there's two main components of the Angikar, if you can say. Like, one is to change management, like behavioral change. So that's the one stream of the Angikar. And the second is the convergence with other schemes. So if we see the objective of the Angikar, to create awareness around those best practices. For example, like water conservation, waste segregation, all those activities. And so this is the first, the social behavioral change that we are talking about, like waste management. And this all relates to the practices that we do on our daily life. So how to manage our waste has to be managed, maybe segregation or dumping at the right place. those kind of activities that will be taken care of. And then water conservation. So as we also we are witnessing the in the at the country level, there is so much of water conservation campaign is being run by Jal Shakti Mission, where everyone is trying hard to conserve the water. So water conservation could have different ways. It could be through rainwater harvesting. It could be through, using judicious use of the water at which we use at the household level. So there could be different ways of water conservation that we'll be talking about. And each ministry is converged with this. So what are their key messages and how the water conservation has to be done? That is the role. The message has to be propagated to the beneficiaries that we'll be interacting it. So the canvas that we have, who are the beneficiary whom we are supposed to reach. So at the first moment, we have basically two. One is the completed houses, all the beneficiaries with the completed houses, plus all the houses that have been grounded. So we eventually, because after a couple of months, they will be also completing. So in this 3 months campaign, many more houses might also be completed and subsequently. And this Angikar is not a first-time campaign. This is just starting for the first time. We'll be doing it for 3 months. And then it will keep on happening after some interval, maybe after 6 months or whatever. So it's a complete, at the end of it, the target that we have today is 1.12 beneficiaries, which are validated as of now. So our target is to reach all of them in phases. So the first phase is start with the completed houses that we have today, and then plus the grounding one, which is roughly more than 50 lakh houses that we have to, that is our bandwidth where we have to reach in our respective states and cities. So then we have will be in with terms to change management, that is energy conservation. So there could be different ways of again the conserving energy. One is through using LED lights. There could be how to use the even if the electricity we are getting, how to use it, like put off your fan and light when you go out. So those kind of practices that has to be communicated. So the TOT guideline and this operational guideline, it has all the details and how in each, around which theme, what kind of key messages that we have to propagate to the beneficiaries and how we have to communicate it. So that all covers about this broadly. So the energy conservation, how we have to do, that's the key message, how we will be doing. Then we have the tree plantation. Greenery is has to be there. So like Jharkhand has been doing, each house will plant at least one tree in their premises and wherever it is possible. And in AHP houses, it's there. The whole plan, the whole layout plan and everything that will include the tree plantation depending upon the availability of the land. So tree plantation is the one major thing that we'll be targeting at. And then we have the health and hygiene. Okay, what is the hygiene practices that we should be doing? Like our Swachh Bharat Mission has been giving, propagating so many messages. So how, this hygiene and the health has to be promoted. So this is the basically 4 or 5 things around which the change which we are looking for, the change management, which we all aspire for, that will be revolving around these 4 or 5 themes. Then we have this convergence model. So for convergence, we have the many ministries which are dealing with all these issues that we are talking about, like say for energy, we are engaged Ministry of Power. Then we have convergence with the Ujala, all the schemes and the ministries. So all these schemes that will be converging together, and there is one committee was formed. And a couple of meetings were already chaired by our secretary, sir. And all these ministries are on board with this. So all the letters has been written to all the respective ministries at the state level also. The letter has gone from our secretary, sir, to the chief secretaries of the states, saying that there has to be to form this committees converging with all these ministries who are concerned with this campaign, where we want to converge. So if you see that we are converging with the SBM, we are converging with the solar energy, the department, and then for Ujala, for LED lighting, then we have health, Ayushman Bharat also. And then we have for LPG connection, and the Water Conservation Ministry of Jal Shakti and all. So these all ministries, we all are working together. So this is what convergence we are looking at. Specifically, we are looking convergence at the service level. The focus is on Ujjwala, which is for gas connection, and Ayushman Bharat. So beneficiaries who have not got any Ayushman Bharat card, which ensures about the scheme where the 5 lakh the family can get free treatment up to the five lakh per annum, and there are empaneled hospitals. So all these details is already written in our guidelines in the TOT manual. So what are the details of the scheme? So we have to get acquainted with all the provisions under each scheme and then connect the beneficiary with them. So primarily we'll be discussing in detail also the need assessment that we are talking about. That will primarily cover in these two aspects. Whether our beneficiary, PMAY beneficiary, whether they have Ayushman card. If they don't have, then how to connect with them. We'll have detailed session on that, how through mobile app we'll be talking to respective ministries, and then how this Ayushman Bharat card can be given. Similarly for the Ujjwala, if the person has not got gas connection, in urban sector there'll be very less number where gas connection will not be there, but there could be various cases in the smaller towns maybe. So how through this scheme we'll be connecting the beneficiary to how he or she should be getting the LPG connection. So these are two primary themes. If you talk about the convergence, these are two major convergence that we are looking at. Then the activities which we are supposed to do on the ground. The first, as sir has already mentioned, that this is Angikar is already being launched by our honorable minister on 29th August. So that was the formal launch. So from now onwards, till 15th of September, we will be doing these trainings. So the purpose of, as I mentioned, the purpose of doing this workshop today, the master trainers, the purpose is, you'll go back to your states and then organize a similar kind of workshop with all your SLTCs and maybe ULB staff that you have to decide. The person at the city level who will be instrumental in doing all these things, all these activities. So they need to be trained. So the first level of this first phase of this Angikar is all the training activity, and then we should be completing it by 15. So a state level training of all the city representatives, and then in turn they will go at their respective cities and they will train the real doer on the ground, like the ARPs which will be called Angikar resource persons. The people, the team which we will be deploying to reach, individual house, door-to-door survey, door-to-door need assessment, the people who will be going, they need to be trained. And they need to be told what kind of, we have already developed IC materials also. They will be going with the mobile app, they will be doing this need assessment, and they'll hand over all those pamphlets and the key messages that is already will be shared with the states. And as states are expected to, we'll be sharing image version of this, all these materials, creative that we have developed, and a state needs to print it and distribute it suitably. So at the first level, by 15, all trainings at the city level also. This is the first national level, then we have a state level training, and then this training will translate into the city level also. So city level, the people who will be trained, who are the ARPs, and that we'll be talking separately, who are the ARPs and how to engage them, all those. So though the training at the city level should happen. So if all the cities, and most of the states, you already have CLTCs. If the number is less, you can call the ULB official, the nodal officer from the ULBs. And they will be, that is the ground where we need to hit. Okay, because if they don't understand these things, if they don't, the message are not clear, so then the message, the outcome which we are targeting, that might not be achieved fully. So this is the first activity that you will be doing. And then after 15th, if we are all trainings are done and ARPs are identified, then after 15th, this need assessment exercise that will be carried out. So as you are already aware, the mobile app already has been developed. So through your mobile app, all need assessment, it is a door-to-door activity. So again, just to reiterate, our canvas is, our bandwidth is, I mean, we can begin with the houses which are completed and end with the houses which are already grounded also. So all needs to be covered. So all these need assessment in BLC houses. I mean, there could be, you can devise a strategy, how many people will be engaged. And because 15 days is the target. In 15 days, we should be, I mean, the idea is we should be doing this need assessment and come out with the result. Because after 2nd October, when this will be finally launched, so we will be able to gather some data, and based on data, all this convergence activity can start. So that that will campaign will be. So this is the first activity. The first is workshops at the state level and the city level, and need assessment. That is the first 35, I mean, this month, and this is a target. Then second activity is the door-to-door activities, with the pamphlets and all this. And third would be the awareness camps. Like that, now from the door-to-door level, the first stage we are doing door-to-door activity. At the second stage, we'll be doing at the ward level. So ward level, you can have the cluster of ward also, and there the strategy will be like Nukkar Natak, street plays, all those kind of activities around these themes. So all estates are requested to engage those Nukkar Natak team and all those who can be doing. We'll be giving you the script, because this message has to be given. Rest depends upon the person and the team that which will be engaging, their creativity, how they want to just communicate this message. But the key messages has to be given. So that we'll be giving you the what are the key messages. You already understand also, but just for the reference, we can give you a kind of guideline. And then after this ward level activity, there will be multiple ward level activities. I mean, in cluster of ward at the ward level, depending upon the number of beneficiaries that we have in each ward. Then the fourth is on 2nd, we'll be launching this scheme at the city level formally. We won't call it the launch, because it is already been launched. It's basically initiation of the activities at the city level. So 2nd October in many states, many cities, and many, you have some kind of celebration of the 2nd October. So at the 2nd October, we have also have to converge with them and plan this activity where our beneficiary also will be called. And then this message at the city level should go, because this the campaign has been initiated formally on the ground. So it will be have both, I mean, door-to-door activities also, and this ward level activities also, this, which will be till 10th December. So this, all these activities should be will be carried out. Depending upon the size of the city, the size of the number of beneficiaries that you have, you have to plan it out at the state level and the city level. Then on 2nd, after formally initiation of this activities on 2nd October, so then we have the culmination event, which will be done on the 10th December. That was for the purpose of, because 10th December is Human Rights Day. So that is why we have thought that this the whole campaign will culminate on 10th December, where all this, I mean, in the process of this campaign, there could be many people who will be partnering with you, maybe Lions Club or maybe students also, because in social, I mean, in the schools also, there has been cases like the people have to do some kind of social work. So you can engage those students, maybe the school or the colleges, who will be given the certificates. So all this ceremony, giving the certificates and acknowledging them, and the whole, the summary, what has been the outcome, these many people, by end of this, the 10th December, we should be have figure like how many people have got new gas connection, how many people have planted trees, how many people have done their rain harvesting pit, how many they have constructed. These are all the, I mean, outcomes and which we can measure. So at the end of this, the culmination day, the whole activity, what is the outcome of this 3 months campaign? So if we get the outcome, then we also will have draw some kind of satisfaction. It's not only just for the sake of doing it by campaign, it has resulted in something. So that is the day on which we count on those things. Okay, what are the benefits that we have gathered in the 2-3 months of the campaign? So these are broad activities. And then the timelines that we have already discussed, launch is done, and till 30th September, the training and need assessment will be carried out. And 2nd October, the campaign will be launched. And then awareness campaign, these 2-3 months will be there. and then 10 this summer will culminate. Then the outcome of this, then we have to measure it, the outcomes. So we have also developed a method where there's a quantitative and qualitative assessment will be done. A person has changed and he has started washing hands, or he is putting, adopting this good practice like putting off the light when you are not there. So that cannot be, of course, measured. Those all aspects are very qualitative in nature. The person is conserving water. For example, like doing shave, he is putting off the tap. So that could be, but we can't measure it. So those are the qualitative indicators, we will be assessing. But the quantitative indicators that we have, we will be measuring, like, as I mentioned, how many trees have been planted, how many water harvesting pit has been done, how many people have availed gas connection, and how many people have got Aushman card, how many people have gone and bought this LED lights, or energy efficient fans. So those are the things that we can count on. So there will be quantitative analysis also. Then we have few committees. The next step, like when you go back to your state, the committee that we have thought of is, one committee at the center level is already formed. Then the second level committee is at the state level, where we are proposing the all principal secretaries of the respective departments who are dealing with all these themes. There will be committee under the chairmanship of the chief secretary. He will have one meeting, and the letter also we mentioned. We requested the chief secretaries of the state to have a video conference with all these state officials. And collectors, they are the most critical factor, because in the bigger cities where the commissioner is powerful, so he can do on his own all the activities and can drive the whole campaign. But in the smaller cities where the population is, say, 25,000, 40,000, where the municipal structure is not very strong, they can drive this thing. Then we are proposing that the collectors of that district should be involved. Another reason why collectors should be involved is there are multiple departments, like the forestry department, the district at the district level. They will be giving the saplings for the plantation drive. There is food and supply department who will be dealing with the gas connection and all. So all these departments, because we are talking about all different departments, and all departments converge at the district level, at the collector level. That is why involvement of the collectors is very, very, very critical. So we are proposing a committee at the district level. And at the corporation, the big corporation, they can have the at the corporation level also. So that is why we have also requested the chief secretary to have a video conference with all the collectors and tell them about the Angikar, to be involved. Just once in a month, the meeting with the collector, that should be enough. So that the convergence can happen. So this is all the whole structure, what Angikar is and what we are looking at. And then how this ARP will be selected, that will be discussed separately. If you have any question, any queries, we are here. So we can discuss separately also. And if you can ask some, so we can also respond to. Yeah. What is the question? See, the idea is, first we have to look at the city level, how many houses are completed and grounded. So, so the number of ERPs, how many people will be deployed, that you can decide upon giving the number. So that our first target is to do it in 15 days. If we get a spillover a week or so, that's not an issue.
Parallelly, we will do the launch event and the IEC activities can continue parallelly.
Actually, the idea is if we have this all the data with us, so at the culmination event also, there will be separate camps, maybe health camps. I mean, during this campaign period also, we can organize, we can, because health ministry is already on board. So we can ask the concerned person there at the district level to organize this kind of camps. This, if we get to the number, say we have 5,000 beneficiary. After 5,000, only 1,000 have this Ayushman card, for example, or 1,000 have gas connection. Then there's need to have a separate camp. So we can request them to organize a camp at the ward level, the city level, I mean, depending on the local situation, so that everyone gets it. So this data we can only derive from the need assessment. So the sooner we do it, that will be our benefit, because we have enough time to get those services connected with the beneficiary. If we keep on doing on that till the end, so convergence, that will be difficult. So we won't be able to measure the impact of this Angikar campaign. Any other?
I would just like to add something. Like this is the first week after the launch of Angikar. The first thing, the first activity we are doing is this master's training. Once you go back, the second week is the most toughest one. Second week means you have to get you have to do the state level workshop, TOT. Moreover, all the formations of the state level and district level committees, that has to be done, and identification of ARPs. And that identification should be in a very transparent way. You can't just hire a ARP. It should be in a very transparent way. It should be approved by a competent authority, either like a district collector or a municipal commissioner, whosoever. It should be approved from a competent authority. So identification process, you should be very clear, because ARP is basically your person who is going to door to door and meeting the beneficiary. So he is carrying your message, entire message of this Angikar. So we have to be very careful in the selection. So once we have just made one assessment, like a person in a day can visit 10 to 12 houses. So in that way only the entire campaign has been designed. So this first activity, though we have designed it for 15 days, in the second, third and the fourth week, it can spill over. As they were saying, it can spill over, but second and the third week, at least we should be able to cover 80% of the entire our target like audience. We should be able to capture, at least we can start with the completed houses, and then we can go to the under construction houses. So that has to be covered. So after that main city level events, like on 2nd October and 10th of December, that should also be planned in a very way. It should create a buzz in that city. It should be properly publicized, properly done. And the entire, these all activities will be captured in an IT platform. We will have a session on the afternoon, and we'll see that entire activity will be captured. Even sir was saying that we can even think of an award also. We are thinking of it, that will award the states also, just as we have already given in the guidelines that you can even award the ARPs also. You can keep some parameters to award the ARPs also, whosoever is covering in the best way or something like that. Even their students and volunteers will be there as ARP. So you can give them certificates also to motivate them. So likewise, we can award the states also on the best, the three states who are doing best in this. We will also be doing impact assessment about through a very independent agency. Said there will be IVRS calls, tele calls. Some agency will be deployed who will be making some sample surveys also. So this has to be taken in a very serious mode, and a very serious planning is required. Thank you.
For this impact assessment also, we'll be discussing separately at the MIS, we've designed a system to have a base level. So all this base level information that has to be fed in MIS, so that after end of it, we are able to measure. And the timeline's important is we visited a state, I won't name them. We visited the beneficiary and told him why this BLC houses are getting delayed. It's been 2 years you're not constructing. So the message given was, since the scheme is till 2022, you keep on constructing. So that should not be the case in the car also. Any other question? Yeah.
So door-to-door service, ward level or city level,
नहीं पहले पहले द फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी इज द वर्कशॉप्स एट द सिटी लेवल. उसके बाद ये आफ्टर 15th September दैट विल डोर टू डोर एक्टिविटी विल बिगिन.
डोर टू डोर लेकिन खाली अवेयरनेस के लिए नहीं है, वो नीड असेसमेंट के लिए भी है. तो वो पहला एक्टिविटी वो करना ही पड़ेगा. वो पहला आपको असेस करना है बेसलाइन डेटा के लिए. बेसलाइन डेटा आपके पास कैसे आएगा?
ये भारत सरकार का निर्णय है,
इसमें आप करने की जरूरत नहीं है. स्ट्रक्चर्ड लाइकवाइज वो आपके अभी आएगा, अभी बताएंगे.
ऐसा रिफ्लेक्शन नहीं दिया हुआ है अंगीकार की वेबसाइट में जो हमने चेक किया इस तरीके से, सो वो ऐड कैसे कर सकते और इसको कन्वर्ट कर सकते या नहीं कर सकते? जी दैट इज मोर इफेक्टिव बिकॉज ऑफ दी जो आप बोल रहे हो लाइफ चेंजेस के रिगार्डिंग. सो ये नंबर ऑफ स्कीम चल ही रही है स्टेट में और उसका यूज हो ही रहा है, तो वो कन्वर्ट हो जाए तो वो बेटर ऑप्शन रहेगा.
क्वांटिटेटिव पैरामीटर्स भी होंगे और प्लस आप देखिए एक तो नीड असेसमेंट के समय आप मोबाइल में है, 5-6 क्वेश्चंस हैं और ये 6 जैसे इस पर ज़्यादा फोकस हो रहे हैं. लेकिन हम आपसे इवन चाहें पहले तो आप जैसे नीड असेसमेंट कर लेंगे एक बार, क्वालिटेटिव और क्वांटिटेटिव आप उसमें पूरा भर देंगे, बेस लाइन डेटा भी भर देंगे कि आपका आज का स्टेटस क्या है. सो देट वी कैन जस्ट गोज कि आप 3 महीने के अभियान में आपने क्या पाया, मतलब क्या आपके आउटकम्स हैं, मतलब तो वहाँ हम लोग ये पैरामीटर्स डाल देंगे जो एनवायरनमेंट क्या बोल रहे हैं कि वेदर एसएचजी मेंबर्स हैं कि नहीं.
यस यस
एम्प्लॉयमेंट वाला आप बोल रहे हैं वो उसका
हाँ. जैसे कि स्कॉलरशिप भी मिलती है एजुकेशन के अंदर जो बंदे को जो 3 लाख की राशि कम है और उसको स्कॉलरशिप मिले हो उससे पूरा उसका लाइफ चेंज हो चुका है. सो वो पैरामीटर्स ऐड हो तो बहुत इफेक्टिव होगा.
दो चीजें जो हृदय कह रहे थे, आई थिंक योर कॉन्सेप्ट अप्लाइज मोर टू एचपी काइंड ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स बिकॉज बीएलसी में मोहल्ले में भी बात हो सकती है, बट एसेंशियली इट इज़ 1-to-1 इंटरेक्शन दैट वी आर लुकिंग एट मोर क्लोजली, पर्टिकुलरली जहाँ ANM आंगनवाड़ी वगैरह इंटरेक्ट करती है. इट इज़ अ डोर टू डोर कैंपेन. अगर आप 10 लोगों को इकट्ठा करके और चीज़ें बता सकते हैं, वृक्षारोपण का अभियान साथ में कर सकते हैं, तो देर इज़ यू नो वी डोंट हैव एन इशू विद दैट. ठीक है, बट एसेंशियली इट इज़ अ 1-to-1 इंटरेक्शन. आप HPK के कॉलोनी में या जैसे 2000 मकान कहीं पर बना है इकट्ठा, वो आप कर सकते हैं. आप इंडियन ऑयल की मदद ले सकते हैं, गैस एजेंसी वालों की मदद ले सकते हैं, CSR एलिमेंट्स वाले को मदद ले सकते हैं. यू कैन यू नो इरेक्ट अ स्मॉल स्ट्रक्चर विशेष तौर से 2 अक्टूबर वाले दिन या इस तरह के दिनों में या बट एसेंशियली द ग्रेन ऑफ द कैंपेन इज डोर टू डोर. ठीक है, बिकॉज हम लोग ये नहीं कह सकते हैं कि लोग को इकट्ठा करके आप वो कर लीजिए. वो तो नुक्कड़ नाटक में ही है, नुक्कड़ नाटक में है, मोबिलाइजेशन में है, जब बच्चे जाएंगे एंड हाउ थिंग्स पैन आउट इन द स्टेट. मतलब आई हैव सफर्ड फॉर 20 ईयर्स ऑन ग्राउंड, तो आई नो कि यहाँ से जो निर्देश जाता है वो परिवर्तित होके, बट इंटेंट आपका क्लियर होना चाहिए कि हमको कैसे पहुँचना है. बिकॉज एवरी सोसाइटी इज डिफरेंट. मे बी यू नो नागालैंड में या किसी ऐसे स्टेट में हो सकता है घर ही इतने दूर हों कि इट बिकम्स सो मच मोर डिफिकल्ट. और अगर मान लीजिए विलेज सोसाइटीज स्ट्रॉन्ग है या लोकल सोसाइटीज स्ट्रॉन्ग है, वी लीव दिस इनोवेशन एंड एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन टू द लोकल लेवल. नाउ रिस्पॉन्डिंग टू भावेन, सी द आइडिया इज कि इस पर बहुत डिस्कशन हुआ था कि वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट एजुकेशन. द पॉइंट इज कि एक प्रजम्पशन ये है या मुद्रा से उसको लिंक कर दें, तमाम स्कीम्स चल रही हैं और उसमें से वी हैव टू प्रायोरिटाइज, बिकॉज कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि पीएमएवाई का जो बेनिफिशियरी है वो हम लोग दूसरे मंत्रालयों के फंक्शंस पे इन्वेड करते रहे, वो बोले भाई हमने मंत्रालय खोल रखा है, ठीक है हम अपना देख लेंगे. सो कन्वर्जेंस हम लोग वो चाह रहे हैं कि जो उनके जीवन में एक अच्छे से परिवर्तन में लाए, बिकॉज स्किल्स की एक बहुत बड़ी इंपॉर्टेंट बात है. स्किल इज एनुअलम इज सर्टनली पार्ट ऑफ देयर, बट स्किल डेवलपमेंट मिशन या मुद्रा या किसी महिला के साथ कोई उत्पीड़न हुआ हो तो वुमेन एंड चाइल्ड डेवलपमेंट कम्स इनटू बीइंग. वी ट्राइड टू मेक इट क्रिस्प, बट एज आई टोल्ड इन माय इनॉग्रल दिस थिंग आल्सो दैट वी लीव सर्टन इनोवेशंस एंड एडिशंस टू द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. वी विल मेक सम इनेबलिंग प्रोविजंस इन दिस थिंग, बट दिस इज प्रीटी मच लाइक, जैसे आपको याद होगा कि दो साल पहले एक साल पहले ग्राम स्वराज अभियान था, ठीक है, तो उस तरह से एक शहर में हम लोग एक अभियान कर रहे हैं. वी आर रिस्ट्रिक्टिंग इट टू अ, जैसे शर्ट्स में आजकल आता है ना स्लिम साइज फिट, ठीक है, वी आर डूइंग दैट, ठीक है, इट्स नॉट अ रेगुलर फिट कि सब में अपना वो करते जाए, लेट इट बी कट एंड क्रिस्प, विच इज़ वाई इट इज़ 3 months. आगे जैसे जैसे लोग जुड़ते जाएंगे उनको एड्रेस करेंगे. नेवरदलेस आई वेलकम इफ, अगर आप कोई जा रहे हैं तो महिला उत्पीड़न पर भी बात कर रहे हैं या कोई बच्चा दिख जाए जो नहीं पढ़ रहा हो, प्रिजम्पशन ये है कि डीबीटी से पैसा जाता है इसीलिए उसको उसका बहुत मतलब है नहीं, बैंक अकाउंट है उसका, नहीं तो हम लोग जनधन की बात किए थे इसमें. एंड सेकंड इशू इज वी प्रिज्यूम दैट मोर ऑर लेस आवर पीएमएवाई बेनिफिशरीज के जो बच्चे हैं शुड बी गोइंग टू स्कूल्स, ठीक है, एंड फॉर अ स्मॉल सेक्शन से मे बी 3% या 5% नहीं जा रहे होंगे या मोटिवेटेड नहीं होंगे, द एंटायर कैंपेन का फोकस जो, बिकॉज एजुकेशन इज सच एन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग एंड इट इज द स्टार्ट ऑफ इट ऑल, कि उससे मे बी पीएमएवाई का वो होगा. बट आई लीव इट अगेन कि ऐसे सोसाइटीज अगर हो जहाँ पे बच्चे ना पढ़ रहे हो तो आई सर्टनली थिंक जो आंगनवाड़ी वर्कर होगा या जो एआरपी होगा हमारा विल डेफिनेटली सेंसिटाइज द पेरेंट्स, बिकॉज देर इज अ राइट टू एजुकेशन नाउ एंड देर इज ऑल्सो अ यू नो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. तो मुझे लगता है कि पीएमएवाई के बेनिफिशियरी शायद उतना ज़्यादा वो ना हो, मे बी वो अगर और अगर कहीं हो तो दैट शुड डेफिनेटली बेटर, दैट इज गोज विदाउट सेइंग.
Just want a clarification on the workshops we'll be having after we go back. So we'll be having this state level workshop once we go back. And before we go to the city level workshop, are we do we have to identify the ARPs before having the city level workshop?
ARPs mostly identified, I would say. For net additions, you may have to. CLTC is already there,
yes,
and surveyors are already there.
Yes.
So they form a very important part of the ARP. Rest the people coming from the SHG members, from NULM, from the Anganwadi workers or ANMs, you leave it to the collector and you know how he will conduct it. But your requirement will squarely depend on roughly say 10 to 15 number of cases per person. So if you have 500 houses and a 15-day campaign, so you divide it by, you know, and you will get the number of approximate number of people you will need. Problem actually will come for states like MP, UP, Tamil Nadu, where the number of houses are way beyond and, you know, they have to do it within a crisp period. Otherwise, for Manipur, what is the your total number of houses under construction? Including CLSS? 18,000. So, 18,000. So, you need to roughly do about 1,200 houses a day. You know, so you will have to decide it on that level. So maybe 100 is the requirement.
100 is the requirement.
So 100 ARPs should not be a big problem.
Yeah, in the workshop, we need to include all those ARPs should be
in the state level. The ARPs will be in the city level training. In the state level training, you will call the only SLTCs, CLTCs, and the ULB, from the ULBs. And in the city level workshop, ARPs will be trained.
In fact, the state level training which you are talking about is just a replica of this one. So there will be master trainers from the cities. Here we are coming from the state at the center. Now the same, the city master trainers should be attending at the state level workshop so that they can go back to the cities and conduct the training. And the difference between this training and that the city level would be, there the all the key messages with the ministry that is written in the book, that has to be explained clearly. यहाँ हम उसकी अभी बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, बिकॉज आपको ये सब पता है, आपको आप मास्टर ट्रेनर हो, तो पूरा आप अंगीकार का सारा आर्किटेक्चर और पर्पस और कैसे रोल आउट करना है, बिकॉज यू आर द स्ट्रेटेजी लेवल. लेकिन जो करने वाले जो लोग हैं एट द सिटी लेवल, जो ARPs होंगे, उनको स्कीम्स की सारी जो की मैसेजेस हैं कैसे होता है उस पर फोकस देना होगा एट द सिटी लेवल ट्रेनिंग. सो व्हेन यू डिज़ाइन योर मॉड्यूल दैट यू शुड फोकस ऑन दैट. एंड एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल से इफ यू इन मणिपुर फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव 28 सिटीज़ आई गेस. सो एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट, इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट से देयर आर फोर सिटीज. सो चार सिटी में व्हाटएवर द नंबर ऑफ कंप्लीशन एंड ग्राउंडिंग इज, डिसाइड द नंबर ऑफ ARPs अकॉर्डिंगली, दैट कलेक्टर विल डिसाइड.
The consultants there really need to talk to the ARPs, and therefore that workshop at both the state and the city level will be extremely important, because one ARP who suppose belongs to PMAY goes for a needs assessment and the person says ki Ayushman Bharat ka eligibility conditions kya hai, or suppose he raises this question that I applied for cylinder, I'm not getting it for 4 months now. What are the terms and conditions and why I'm not getting it? So without getting into an embarrassing situation of, you know, not trying to dodge the issue, they should be able to explain clearly and also have shared their numbers at local level so that they are able to sort the issue out. You also will have to keep a check on that messaging zyada na ho jaye, you know, that he goes and I went to a particular state, I'll not name, where the surveyor was probably as important a person as I would have never imagined, because he was being, you know, he was bloating under the largesses of that beneficiary's family and, you know, getting a lot of things to eat and all that. So you have to make them understand that this is not a fleecing campaign. They have to go and address a cause. So you will have to keep a check on them, and which is why the central observers and the role of SLNA. कि कई लोगों को बहाना मिल जाता है, आई हैव डन 9 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड नो, कि कोई कैंपेन चला और उसमें ऐसे लोग जुड़ गए जो कि फिर वो जाके कि आपको हम दिलवा रहे हैं गैस कनेक्शन, आपको हम दिलवा रहे हैं आयुष्मान कार्ड, 300 रुपये दे दीजिए, 500 रुपये दे दीजिए, दीज थिंग्स दे डोंट नॉट हैव टू, यू नो, एक समाज में एक हमारा जायका है कि हम वैसे ही खाते सेवा करते हैं, ठीक है, बट इट शुड नॉट गो बियॉन्ड यू नो द नॉर्मल domains of the social experience that we get want.
Door-to-door activity important is liye hai, like in PMAY, geotagging was introduced. The purpose was introducing in BLC first, the house is getting actually made to ensure this. Similarly, in Angikar also, like aapka UP hai, bade bade states hai, if you are engaged ARP but you don't have any control, तो उसमें प्रोविजन ये है कि द बेनिफिशियरी इफ ही इज गोइंग टू विजिटिंग द बेनिफिशियरी ही हैज़ टू अपलोड ए फोटो ऑन दिस दैट फ्रॉम दिस मोबाइल ऐप. तो यू रियली नो कि द पर्सन हैज एक्चुअली विजिटेड. तो एक तो एक तरह से चेक, एक चेक वो है. और जितने लोग भी यहाँ पे अभी हैं, वी ऑल हैव गैदर्ड, आप इससे आने से पहले वर्कशॉप से पहले बहुत डिस्कशन हुआ कि हु शुड बी पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन द वर्कशॉप. सो बहुत पर्पसफुली ये आइडेंटिफाई किया गया कि कौन लोग इस वर्कशॉप में आएंगे. So now you are here, so you all are the drivers of this whole campaign at the state level. तो आपका जो role होगा कि city level training हो रही है नहीं हो रही है, कहाँ पर हुई, कितनी नहीं हुई, ARP किस city ने नहीं की, जैसे कि आपका जो SLTC होता है state का, वो scheme के सारे components को देखता है, कहाँ पर geo tagging कमज़ोर है, कहाँ पर साहब MIS की entry नहीं हो रही है, कहाँ पर construction वो है, तो आप सारा monitor करते हो. तो इसी तरह जितने भी लोग हैं state से जो आए हैं आज, इनकी ये हम ये थोड़ी responsibility में लेनी पड़ेगी कि ये जो स्टेट लेवल एक्टिविटीज़ और सिटी लेवल पर रोल आउट हो और सही से चले वो, तो हमारा एंगेजमेंट पूरे कैंपेन पीरियड में होगा बहुत ही कंटिन्यूस बेसिस पे कि ये एक्चुअली हो रहा है कि नहीं हो रहा है.